Hey, what's going on, everybody? Kevin L. Johnson from Ozark, and you're watching EC Sports.
Yeah, yo, check it. Turn me up a little bit on the mic. EC Sports, episode... I'm not saying Lance Briggs. I already fucked that up. 55. Otis Wilson. Dikembe Mutombo.
Derek Brooks.
Or Derek Brooks, yeah. I mean, you got three good ones there. What do we got? New show ready to go.
New show ready to go. We got NBA Finals, a weak display last night from the Heat. I think we'll get into that. I think it's going to get ugly. I really do. I thought so before last night's game, and now I really think so. Obviously, we have that EC fantasy, kind of summary synopsis, kind of headed into the next week type action. And then, most importantly, I mean, been waiting to talk about this for so long, but the Bears, 3-0. On the road to 10-6, looks like you're
pretty much sounds like what I said.
Looks like you might be buying me dinner again soon.
That bet on record?
That bet is on record.
I don't know, man.
And I cannot wait to talk about Nick Foles. So let's get into today's episode. Let's start off with the NBA Finals. So Finals last night. What do you take away from it?
I mean. Hey, he came out strong, kind of like underdogs do. I don't really consider them an underdog like the Nets because they played so tough. But when you're coming up against a player and team led by LeBron James, it's just hard to fathom what you could do to get through that. We've said this numerous times that he's just this generation's. That doesn't mean he is Jordan. He's just this generation's Jordan, where you're probably not going to be able to win unless you go through him, which is semi-impossible. So they showed their true grit last night.
Yeah, no, and you know what? I completely agree. In favorable of the Lakers, they're probably the best team that the Lakers can face.
Okay.
Because of both size. To me, it's like Bam is amazing player. I love the way he plays, but he's like 6'9" at the center.
Yeah.
Against an Anthony Davis, so the matchup there is horrible. But then when you look at their four, it's Derrick Jones, who's like a high flyer who could basically play the two or the three on the Lakers.
Totally.
Where now you've got a guy who's playing the four up against like, you know, a LeBron or a Kuzma, somebody who's 6'10", 6'9", when they're only 6'7". But then you got Jimmy Butler, who's the guy who I feel is most comparable to Jimmy Butler, really, from an athletical standpoint, would be LeBron.
Yeah. And, you know, they had some injuries that hurt, that are going to hurt them. So weird watching Dragic get injured. He thought he stepped on something. That's how they say that injury feels like. And then Jimmy turned his ankle, but we're talking Jimmy. And then Bam with the shoulder. So when you're in the East and, you know, they didn't have a very long, track to get there until like the end. But it's just like when you're going against like you got a beast just sitting in his room waiting. You know, and they're calling him to come to the ring. Hey, champ, it's time to go. And, you know, the Heat are just the glass Joe, so to speak, of Mike Tyson's punch out. Like, let's just get out here and get bust, unfortunately. I thought they would give them a better run, but it's not over yet. We'll see what happens.
Right. I mean, it's only one game. So with the matchup at hand, we've seen a little glimpse of it last night. What do you think the final outcome? What would you say the final outcome as far as the series record and winner of the series is going to be?
Initially, I thought it was going to be Lakers in six. Now I'm looking more of a sweep or five.
I say, you know, I got to agree with you. I think it's either going to be a sweep, or I think Hero is going to have one huge game against like a Danny Green or one of them.
This dude's a Hero. Why? Because he has your hair. That's why you said Hero.
I mean, you see what I'm doing here with this Hero hair.
Yeah.
But at the point is, Hero is realistically maybe the best scorer on that team right
wow.
now.
That is a that's a statement there.
That's a statement. Jimmy Butler is a two-way player, amazing player, can do it all. But Tyler Hero,
actually, his name is Jimmy Buckets. Thank you.
Can do it all, two-way player. But from a scoring standpoint, I really do like Tyler Hero. That dude finds ways to get to the free throw line. He hits shots. He's good from beyond the arc. He has to have a huge game for them to get one game in this series. I really believe that.
What about Duncan Robinson?
Duncan Robinson's going to be Duncan Robinson. He's going to be the guy who spends most of his career around the three-point line, hustles here and there to make a couple, you know, little highlight plays. But other than that, I don't think Duncan Robinson can – I don't see him taking over a game in the finals because – I just feel like a team like the Lakers is too big. I think they put guys – I think they have athletic big guys. Kuzma's a big guy who can run with guys. LeBron's a big guy who can run with guys. Davis is a big guy who can run with guys. Shit, honestly, Dwight Howard off the bench is a big guy who can run with guys.
Did they start him? I didn't see the first part.
No, they didn't start him.
They started the last game, so I was wondering. Also, the rookie has to come in and take over with Dragic being out. And he had some good garbage moments, so we'll see what happens.
None went to Simeon, by the way. Shout out Chicago. None, Kendrick. But, hey, the bottom line is, I agree. The youth is just too – The youth is light on this team, and I just don't see them. I don't see them doing it. LeBron is. He's in.
Where did Nunn go to college?
Nunn went to a real small school.
Let me check the Shefty.
I'm pretty sure it was a really small school. I could be wrong, but I think it was.
Okay.
I think it was a weird.
Oh, okay. He went to he went to Illinois and then he went to Oakland University.
Yeah.
So he transferred?
Yeah, I thought it was a small school. Yeah,
he went to Illinois 13-16 and then he went to Oakland University. Unless it's the other way around. Yeah, that's interesting. Oakland.
Really a great draft pick. I mean, the guy had a great year.
Simeon produces good players, man. I mean,
they produce good bench players.
Yeah, I mean, except for Derrick Rose.
You're looking at a program where the bench players go D1.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah, Simeon is a sought-after school in Chicagoland area. For those that don't know, so what do we got next? Obviously, the finals are self-explanatory.
EC Fantasy, because I do want to save. Something that, you know what, I want to save it because it's an I told you so moment from the boys at EC Sports.
Oh yeah, it is. Yeah. But before we get to fantasy, I have an I told you so moment and I want a public apology. Public apology to Cameron fucking Newton from D'Amato. Right now, go.
So I've already given him the private apology. So I'm going to go ahead and give him the public apology. And I'm going to do the public apology with absolute ease, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. I got to say, I always watched the Patriots because of Tom Brady. I always did. But this is going to sound crazy, but watching the Patriots right now almost gives me the same feeling when I used to watch it with Tom. That's how good of a job Bill and Josh McDaniels have done implementing Cam Newton into the offense. I am absolutely stunned by what they've been able to do. I must say, Cam Newton, the way he's playing right now, the longevity of his career has added 2 to 3 years on so far. I love the way he's playing. He's taking what's given to him finally. You could see that that's panning out with a coach who understands his abilities. But what they've been able to do around him, obviously they have a stout defense, a great secondary. But the play calling scheme that they've put around Cam Newton, it's like
McDaniels like had that playbook like ready as soon as they signed him. He's like, oh shit, wait. Like he knew, I'm getting this fucking physical specimen that dudes are scared to tackle. Just like Gruden said, slam Newton. He's a power forward at the QB. Bro, if you take away one play, they're 3-0.
No, I agree. And you know what? That was the only play that I've seen thus far that I thought was a bad play call.
Yeah, it was. Because I knew it was coming.
Because everybody knew it was coming.
Yeah, totally.
Play is so staged.
Come on,
that
Josh
goes in motion to line up in the same formation that they run the same play out of. It's a matter of, hey, we're going to do this. You stop it.
Exactly. That's exactly what it is.
But at that moment in the game, I like to say, hey, we're going to motion this guy over. We're going to do this, but I'm going to switch it up this much to put it right in your ass at the end of the game.
Yeah.
So what I thought would have been a good call there was that same motion, attack the line of scrimmage like he did, and then dump one right over the top of everybody.
What if Cam would have gotten in trouble if he checked out of that?
No, I thought maybe it was a stage play. I mean,
yeah,
listen,
no.
A good coaching staff. Yeah. By the playoffs, they will have stage plays out of that formation, out of that look. There will be some sort of staging going on.
I mean, that defensive player did what he's taught to do, which is bust up what's coming, and that's what he did. And it made – Cam's a big dude, and we saw what happened. But with all that being said, Cam's been killing. I'm looking forward to this week's game. I didn't bet on it because it was a great – KC.
Oh.
Give me a tough one. But listen.
Hey, I'm going to say – Patrick Mahomes is the best I've ever seen.
Hey, he is. You hear about that guy winning $30,000 on DraftKings?
No. What happened?
They had a fucking – which is how they got me addicted. But they had this thing. Oh, hey, just anyone that just bet on the first player to score, and we'll give you these odds. But this one wasn't like the other one. These odds were whatever you want to bet. Dude put $1,000 down and won $37,000. Just Pat Mahomes just had to score first.
So the one he ran in?
Yeah. He just had to cross the line. He couldn't be a pass. He had to score. And that's what he did. Can you imagine? And that's not a hard bet if you got 100 or 1,000 laying around.
That's a big risk to put $1,000 for the quarterback to score.
$1,000 is a lot. Would I have done 50 to 100 to get $3,000?
Yeah. Like, if you did the running back, I could see it. But 1,000 on the quarterback scoring?
We're talking Mahomes.
But listen, that guy is
– yeah.
I've never seen anything like it.
He's a monster among men, let's be honest with you.
What he's doing.
What he wants. And the fact that they are undefeated is not hard to understand. So
it's the perfect storm, though. You're looking at the greatest play. I said it the other day. I think this guy is the greatest play caller, offensive play caller I've ever seen. There was a drive as a coach, sometimes I watch the game. This guy put a drive together where he called three plays that were they were mind-blowing, outrageous insanity. That double swing screen and then dump the ball in the middle, ghosted by lineman to a 6'7" all-pro tight end that nobody even seen.
Barry Hand, was it Kelsey?
It was ridiculous. It was like this way, turn around, this way, turn around, middle defense, of the fucking field.
Defense is lost. And again, remember, we had mentioned this on EC Sports. This is a guy that just learned this past season how to read defenses out of his own mouth. So,
how about a play where you have the rookie running back, Clyde, you have Kels, you have Hill, you have Watkins, and now you have another burner in Hardman. And who does this guy fucking give the ball to on the goal line? The fullback, Anthony Sherman, dude. Wow. This guy fakes the balls around and underhand shovel passes a ball to the
fullback. Wants, bro.
Last guy in the field, maybe in the stadium, who would get the ball.
He does playground plays, and he gets away with them, let's be real. We're 18 in. Let's get to the fantasy. I have the scoreboard from last week up right now. First, I'm going to go with Raheem Mostert. That's my team. We beat the undefeated Julio Think You Are. And that put us in first place. We're 2-1. You know, like I said, it's a strategic season. Lose the first one on a tough loot loss. And you come back and, you know, beat the guy that's undefeated. Next, you might want to change your name since he's not on your team. Have some class and pay attention. Trip Deshaun. Mr. Wally World, the champ. You lost to the champ, so that's serviceable.
I lost to the champ.
Yeah, he is 2-1 as well. Yeah, what'd you say?
He Mahomed me, bro.
Yeah, he did. He did some things.
He Mahomed me. I was winning by a decent margin going into that game.
But he's got Lance. He's got Lamar. So that was a interesting one. But I don't think Lamar is the one that got you. But yeah, so now you are 1-2. You came out of the gates. You're 1-2 now. My barber, Haterville, got options. He beat Dylan. Seems like there's a trend here where guys beat my son, then they got me the following week. How that happened, I don't know. But I'll avenge my kid's loss as I did this week.
Pretty good. I like his team.
You like that team?
His team I like.
Because he's got Mahomes, and he lost two in a row, but I think he got caught by who he was going against. I think, what's the dude from Buffalo? Which, by the way, Spiro. I'm wearing this because I like the hat, before you say something. What's the quarterback?
Josh Allen?
Yeah, dropped 74 on him.
That guy is a monster.
400 yards. Rush passing, and then he rushed a couple, so that happened. That
guy running defenders over like he's Earl Campbell. Yeah.
And with no fear, though.
Oh, my God.
And then the last two games, you got Eric, who finally got a win, which is embarrassing to the person that he beat. Lance, you lost to Eric. That's all I got to say for that. Northwest Ricky Lake. Wow, this is a high-scoring game. Old host versus the two-minute drill. Two-minute drill is no longer undefeated. 210 to 207. That was a high-flying game, bro. Yeah, that shit was crazy. But he's got Josh Allen, 66 points. Allen is killing, bro. 311, five total touchdowns. But he's got Kamara, bro. He's got Josh Allen and Kamara.
This guy's got Stephon Diggs. The Vikings were acting like Stephon Diggs was this loudmouth fourth grader. They would fucking stand outside the stadium begging for him back right now in Buffalo.
Oh, absolutely. Totally. So
they're brutal.
Like I've always said, man, it's a 14-game season. I believe that, you know, you're in your situation, you lost the best player in the league. So things happen that way. I have the GOAT and Drew Brees, which I'm going to give some unknown secrets that only Dylan knew. I was planning on trading one of them because they were pissing me off, but I had to give them 3 weeks. You know, now they're dropping 50.
Old man Drew turns the TV on. He hears the doubters for like 10 minutes. He comes out slinging.
Yeah, and I think he's got like the Lions or something this week. So I took that with no weird worry. So, yeah, I'll avenge you again, Dylan. That's what daddy's supposed to do. Hopefully you can catch up because I know you use your own money for this league and I know you want to win. But we got about 5 minutes left. I'm going to give you the show. It's time to go.
Fucking Dick comes in there throwing fucking dimes. That's all I got to say, baby. Down 16. Not a lot of time to go. We got an asterisk next to his interception, by the way. Should have been a score. Should have won this one big.
Yeah.
But it, I got to say, compelled by this performance. The fact to say that I'm excited to see this weekend's game is an understatement.
You bet
on it. You're talking about a guy here who has come off of the bench to win the Super Bowl, who now comes into a game on the road, ice cold, no practice with the ones, by the way.
With the shield.
With the XFL shield on. XFL Vinnie McMahon shield on. Dark. Comes in there. For me to say that this guy comes in there and absolutely controls. Like, the team looked like they were shot with adrenaline on the sideline. They got shot up with adrenaline.
Yeah, it was like they were waiting for that.
It was like receivers suddenly were open, but were they open or have they been open the whole fucking game and this guy didn't see anybody because that's what he normally does?
Do you think that's – I mean, I know this is a question I can probably answer myself by asking it, but do you think it's an unspoken thing that – players just shut the fuck up knowing that some guys should not be playing?
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Because if you're that guy.
Listen, this happens from young ages all the way to the pros. There's teams you look at where you look at one guy and you say, his backup might be better than him. Or, oh, I don't know why the coach has such a hard-on for this guy. There's a guy on the sideline over here who's just as good, if not better, and he doesn't get a free shot. But here's what
the Bloomingdale Bears.
Here's what the main thing is. The main thing is, people laugh. I always say this word, moxie. I always talk about moxie. People say, oh, Mitchell's got better moxie. He has the ability to run and scramble. Here. Did you see the clip of Nick Foles on a timeout prior to throwing that score? Did you see that clip?
No, explain it.
He tells Anthony Miller, this is an un-Trubisky type. Trubisky couldn't do this. In 10 years from now, he wouldn't be able to do this. He tells Anthony Miller, I've been reading. Now, he's been in the game for a quarter. I've been reading the all-out blitzes. If we line up and I read all-out blitz, I want you to run to the L in ATL. That's what he told them.
Wow.
If I get all-out blitz, it's going to be man coverage. I want you to run across the field to the L in ATL. I'll put the ball there. You know what kind of balls you have to have to call game on something like that?
Bro, at that
shot, what's it right? Go watch that clip. It's on the fucking L.
The practice squad player. Let's see how that looks.
Third down and 8 with the Bears already in field goal range. The pass is caught in the end zone for a touchdown by Anthony Miller.
And that's like something that you would think, that can't happen in the NFL. But it's simple, bro. People make things so strategic and hard. When you make it simple, people strive. And that's anything. Anything you do. But everybody wants to be, you know, what they are. So go ahead.
There was an absolute tell-all, though, in that game. So the halftime reporter comes out in the beginning of the third. They said, you know, you spoke with Nagy headed into the locker room. What did he have to say? The tell-all for me was that he said, we have to do better. We have to do this. We have to do that. She said, I asked him about the missed throws. He said, he looked at me in disappointment, shook his head, and said, we have to make those throws. To me, that was a defining moment in this Bears team, because usually, time and time again, a guy you're looking at here who would defend him at all costs.
And it's gone.
Finally, he
said, get tired, bro.
He's got to fucking do – he's got to make it.
Yeah.
If he doesn't make it, to me, I'm like, wait a minute, we might have holes here.
It's over. What I'll give Nagy, and we'll wrap up, is he tried, bro. He gave him every opportunity, and now it's time to move on. He's got his job to hold, too. So right. Let's head out to fantasy land in Chicali and see what Danny has to say about this week's events for Ant. Raiders. Sorry. Morant, this is Deion, EC Sports.
What's going on, everybody? It's your host, Daniel Malakismo, back again with the EC Sports West 2-Minute Drill. I know it's been a couple weeks. Great to see you guys once again. Deion, Anthony, how's everything going? Let's get this thing started. We got a lot of topics to cover, including the NBA Finals, MLB Wildcard Playoffs, and, of course, the NFL. Let's kick things off with the NBA Finals in the bubble. I know it's October. It's supposed to be preseason. Media days going on, but obviously due to 2020 and the coronavirus, we're now in the NBA Finals. The Miami Heat and the Los Angeles Lakers are taking on each other, the top two teams in the bubble, the best two records in their conferences, respectively, during the bubble time. LeBron James, Anthony Davis is taking on Jimmy Butler and company. And after game one, it looked like the Lakers are going to dominate the series. 116-98 Finals. After game one, Anthony Davis putting up dominant numbers of 34-9, while LeBron James doing his usual thing of near triple-double numbers. Now, Jimmy Butler and the Heat are not going to back down, even though they do have Goran Dragic possibly out for the rest of the series and Bam Adebayo on a strain of the shoulder neck area. Butler says, we're not going to back down from anyone. He's got a lot of grit, dropped 23 points yesterday. Let's see how they can come back going into game two and possibly even up the series at 1-1. With the NBA Finals among us, we also have the MLB Wildcard Weekend going on with this 60-game COVID season. Now, this new 16-team playoff format is pretty fun and pretty interesting, especially for fans. It starts off with a 3-game playoff series and then goes into the divisional round. Teams like the Dodgers are up 1-0. The Yankees won their series against the Cleveland Indians. The Minnesota Twins haven't won a playoff game in over 15 years, and both Chicago teams are in must-win positions. The Chicago White Sox are tied 1-1 with the A's. The Cubs are down 1-0 against the Marlins. Who knows? I mean, this is a very interesting year. This is a wide open playoffs, especially for teams that were powerhouses like the Dodgers, like even the Padres. They're down 1-0. So this is a really great way to introduce the MLB playoffs into this wild card series. Now, as bad as injuries were these first 3 weeks of the NFL season, especially for fantasy owners, how selfishly could we think? But for honestly, for these superstars who have gone down, the coronavirus outbreak in the Tennessee-Pittsburgh matchup has been the topic of the week. You got the Tennessee Titans having nine people on their staff. I don't know if it was players and staff members, but affected by the coronavirus, shutting down the facilities and postponing the game. Now, how long will this last? Will it be 1 week? Will it be 2 weeks? What day are they going to replace that game? Are they going to have it in a midweek? These are all the interesting questions that arise when you have a league like the NFL who doesn't play in a bubble like the NBA or the NHL, how they did their playoffs. This is a league and organization that's having everyone travel, and there are some stadiums that have fans in it. So these are all the interesting questions going into this 2020 season, how crazy it's going to be and how whirlwind of a season it's going to be. So we'll just have to see, right? And that'll wrap things up here at the EC Sports West 2-Minute Drill. By the way, shout out to the Tampa Bay Lightning, who did win the Stanley Cup Finals in the NHL bubble. Congrats to them and their fans, organization, the team. For everybody else, stay safe, stay positive. Deion, Anthony, out.